Listening Library presents The Perfect Star by Rob Buyea. Read for you by Robbie Daymond, Abigail Revasch, Ozzie Rodriguez, Todd Haberkorn, and Caitlin Davies.
1. Summertime Blues. Gavin. I'd said it before, and I would say it again. Babies popped out looking uglier than a linebacker. But for some, that ugliness turned into cuteness by the time the toddler phase rolled around. It was a fact. Once you got them past that poopy diaper stage, the baby started looking and smelling better. What made me the expert on this stuff? My little sister Meggie. Meg's was good and ugly in the beginning, but nowadays it didn't matter where we were. As soon as people saw her, the oohs and ahs would start. And that was always followed by, "She's so cute." I would just laugh. If these people only knew that my precious little sister was the same cutie pie who tried to eat cigarette butts off the ground in the Foodland parking lot. Granted, that was when she was 3, but still. And it wasn't long ago that Meg's needed help wiping her butt and a reminder to wash her hands after using the bathroom. She was also the same peanut who shared her bed with our very large and slobbery bull mastiff, Otis. By morning, she would have a mouthful of Otis hair and a soaking wet pillowcase, but she didn't care, and neither did the rest of the world, because here was the other thing about Meg's. She was a little person with a great big vocabulary. She was only going into first grade, but she liked using grown-up words when she talked, and that just made her cute card even stronger. It was her whole package that gave her the superpower ability to melt hearts, and we were going to need all of that to save our family this time around. I was firing another pass through my trusty tire target when Meggie yelled, "Gavi, Daddy needs your assistance." Assistance? See what I mean? She scared me pretty good by yelling like that when I wasn't ready for it, so my throw sailed high. It was the first pass I'd missed all afternoon. Blockhead Otis ran and snatched my football and raced around with it in his mouth. "Drop it!" I shouted. Fat chance. I had to go and grab one of his tennis balls from near the porch, and then he came bounding over and dropped my football. The stupid dog was smart enough to know I'd throw his tennis ball for him all day long if he captured my football first. So who was the dumb one? I chucked his ball across the yard, and he tore after it. Then I turned to Meg's, ready to yell at her for scaring me like that, but instead, I burst out laughing. She had grease and dirt smeared across her upper lip. "What?" she whined. "Nothing." I wasn't going to tell her. Cute or not, she was still my little sister. "What's Dad need help with?" I asked. She shrugged. "He didn't say." I picked up my football and wiped it clean on my quarterbacking towel. "Let's go see." We walked around the side of the house, and I saw that Dad had the jack slid under the front of Mom's car. "You're going to be driving before we know it," he said. "Figure it's time you learn how to change a flat. Not everything can be about football, you know." "I know," I said, even though football was all I could think about these days. Preseason would be starting soon, I hoped. The school still hadn't hired a new coach. Dad got down and showed me where he'd positioned the jack under the car and how he'd stuck a block of wood behind the back tire to keep it from rolling. "Safety first," he emphasized. "Always safety first." I nodded. He handed me a screwdriver and the lug wrench. "Pop the hubcap and loosen the lug nuts," he said. "Then jack her up and take the wheel off." It took all the horsepower I could muster to loosen a few of those nuts, but I got it. Then I raised the car, pulled the flat off, and slid the new tire on. Dad showed me how to give everything a final tightening after we had the car back on the ground, because that kept the wheel from spinning when you cranked on the wrench. Same reason why he'd had me loosen the lug nuts before jacking it up. "Margaret," Dad said, "you see this?" He pointed to a small puddle by the side of the car. "You want to make sure Otis doesn't go drinking puddles that are near vehicles, like this is. If it's the wrong stuff, it could kill him." "Okay, Daddy," Meggie said, her eyes big. I do a good job of making sure there's nothing bad out here, because I don't want any accidents, but it's good for you to be paying attention too. She nodded some more. Too bad that wasn't the only thing we had to be careful of when it came to Otis and accidents.
Mija, can you come inside for a minute?
Mom called from the front porch.
Coming,
Maggie yelled.
Come on, Otis. Mommy requests our company.
Me and Dad chuckled as the partners in crime ran off. Then Dad turned and tossed me the keys. Time to take her for a test drive, don't you think? He hopped in on the passenger side, and I stood there. He rolled down his window. Let's go.
You're serious?
Yes. My old man had me driving when I was your age. Now come on, before your mother stops us. My mother had gotten in trouble for driving without a license, and now Dad was telling me to do it. My eyes popped in disbelief, but I didn't waste another second. I hopped in behind the wheel and stuck the key he'd handed to me in the ignition, but that was as far as I got. I couldn't get the key to turn. Dad started cracking up. I felt my face growing red. I tried again. Nothing. This car can be finicky, he said. Give the steering wheel a yank and try her again. I'm so stupid, I thought. I did what he said and turned the key, and the engine came to life. Now push the brake in and put the car in drive, Dad coached. I did. Ease off the brake. I did, and we crept forward. Give it some gas, big shot, he encouraged. I gave it too much, and we shot forward like a lineman firing out of his stance. That startled me, so I mashed the brakes, and we slammed to a stop.
You trying to make me a human milkshake? Dad said. Go easy with the pedals. You don't need to stomp on them.
He chuckled. I took a deep breath like before a big play and tried again, and this time I did better. Dad had me drive around the hills. We stuck to the back roads, so we didn't see any other cars, which was good, because I didn't know what I'd do if that happened. I would have driven by Randy's house so I could show off, but she was busy training for gymnastics. She had a big event coming up, so she was putting in extra time. I did a pretty good job driving for my first time behind the wheel, until we got back home. I forgot to slow down before pulling into our driveway. I took the turn so fast, Mom's car came up on two wheels. I yanked the steering wheel and mashed the brakes again, and we slammed to another instant stop. I put the car in park and sat there, shaking, but Dad burst out laughing, which made me feel better.
Well, you've got some improving to do, but not bad, he said.
I turned the engine off and handed him the keys. That was enough for one day. Little did I know how important this early training would be for later.
RANDI. The way seventh grade had ended had been terrific. I really couldn't have asked for anything more. We had Mrs. Woods and Mrs. Magenta together again. Mrs. Davids was home. And then I finished the year off by winning the gymnastics all-around title at regionals. The hug Mom and I shared when I met her on my way into the awards area was one of extreme happiness mixed with relief. After years of hard work, I was finally regional champ. I'm so proud of you, honey, she said into my ear, squeezing me tighter. You were amazing today. Thanks, Mom. Coach Andrea and Mom hugged next. Then a man I hadn't noticed before stepped forward. Congratulations, Andrea. Thank you, Jacob, she replied. Jacob? Wait, what? The man turned to face me. RANDI, this is Jacob, Mom said. This is Jacob, I repeated in my head. The man Mom has been talking to since Coach Andrea introduced them last year, and the man she went to see during April break. This is Jacob? The man Mom has feelings for? He offered me his hand, and I shook it. He was tall and good-looking. Congratulations, RANDI. You were wonderful out there. Your floor routine was beautiful, he said. Thank you. Next up is the USA Summer Showcase, Coach Andrea said. You qualified with your scores today. I smiled.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.